Welcome to DWBIADDA channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hi, welcome to DWBIADDA Angular tutorials. So, in the last tutorial, we have discussed about the providers. So, today we are going to discuss about the HTTP calls and observables. So, what are observables? Basically, you create a provider and call it a service. So I have already explained you what is the use of that. So here you can see that I have created some of the HTTP calls. I have already discussed this code in one of the last tutorials, but now I have made some different modifications into this code. So what's happening here is there is a function getData, and this is a data service with a provider which has been already declared in app.module.ts. As I can show you here, it has been configured as providers. So from the code, say for example from this first .html or first.component.ts file, what we are doing, we have imported this data service as an conf data, and we have a variable which is denoting the get data service and subscribe to it. If we want to pass any data to this get data function, we can mention that data over here. Say for example we want to pass an ID, then we can mention here ID, or we can pass name and we can mention here name. So this data will be received by this function here. Mentioning the type n, and this data can be passed to the get request like this. Data is equal to plus, or either you can say p is equal to data. So this will be passed to this API. This API could be a local URL. Right now we are pointing this to the local URL. This is this file which is stored here. So this is the file we are talking about. And we are hitting this. And we are getting the data. And what is this section doing? This is a very important section, that it is, whatever the response we are getting, it is mapping that data through this dot process data function. So whatever the response we will get from this API, this will be coming to this process data. And here what we can do, we can just make modifications to the data, because it is not necessary all the time it will come from in a required format. So you can here make changes into the data response, and that data response is going to be returned and then return and then will be received by this subscribe. And then you can, like, I have already consoled it, so okay, let's run the project and see how it's. So here our project is up and running. So we are calling this API, which is this data, and we are receiving this data here and we are consoling it. So while I just reload the project, so the project is reloaded now. Here you can say we see that we have received the status 200, then we have received some data input. So this is our topics. We can see ID topic 234 this, and we have received this from this file. You can see the ID topic this. And this is our JSON which we are using here, data.data.topics, and we are sending this to data.render. So this is basically API call which is sending the data to the HTML to render. So here we are using some part of the material Angular. Here we are having ng4. And data to render is a data to render variable in which we are storing the data we received from an API call. This is data to render is, you see here it is an array chunks. So 0, 1, 2, 3, you can so on and so on, you can see receive number of different array chunks. So here it is making all those different array chunks into single variable in a single variable. So if you see here, what we have in the 0 is the name, and name is equal to the sports. So what we have done here, so we have took one array out of the data to render into the single, and here in the material angle title tag we have printed the name, and then in the description part we have this description. So it is sports and dot 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 dot, this is the description. So we have printed single description over here. This part over here is the index of the array. So index of the array is this key, this 0, this key, this key 0, 1. So this will be looped here, and then after this, wherever this mat expansion panel tag is closing, till then this single will be available within the tags. So as you can see, I have used it here, I have used it here, and we, according to the project requirement, we have different code. So sometimes you don't receive data in this format. Might be this ID is not there, might be name is somewhere hidden underneath here. So what do you do while fetching the data in process data over here? Like, you can create your own, say for example, let's process the data here and then change the data JSON of the API response. We'll do this in next tutorial. So stay tuned, and thank you.